Hello everybody, my name is Doomfish, and today's video I'm going to be showing you how you can enchant items using books using the least amount of levels possible. So a lot of the time, especially in the late game where you have your villagers set up, you're going to be using a lot of books to enchant your items. So you can get mending enchantments, basically any enchantment in the game, for a very, very low price, and it's definitely worth doing to reliably get the best enchantments in the game. The only problem is that this can take a lot of levels if you do not know how to enchant your items perfectly. In this video, I'll show you a couple of different tricks you can use to use the absolute minimum level count possible to enchant all of your items. So the first thing to note here is that different books and different enchantments have different costs associated to them. So for example, something like your Soul Speed 3 can have a cost of 12 levels, while something like Mending can only have a cost of 2 levels. And to use this, we're going to want to pair up our books and our items. So right here, I've got the absolute maximum number of enchantments you can have on one item, which is 7, and we're going to put them all on this book, or on this pair of boots right here. And we're going to put them all on this pair of netherite boots right here. So we're going to pair them up. We're going to pair them up so that items of equivalent cost are sort of together. And if you have an item that's of a certain high cost enchantment, we're going to pair that up with the boots. So we're going to have these two items paired. And then our thorns is also 12, and our feather falling is 4. Which is pretty good because we can use this item to pair it up with this and it will reduce the costs a lot. And I'm just going to pair these up like so. The pairing up of the items is a little bit less important, and there's a bit more detail on the wiki page that I'll be linking in the description. Also, you can see the enchantment costs of every single enchantment in the game. That's a very helpful tool for absolutely reducing your enchantment costs. But as you can see, I've got these grouped up, so I've got Mending and Breaking grouped up. I believe Unbreaking is 3 levels, Mending is 2. And so on. Protection and Depth Strider are, I think, 6 and 4, respectively. And then Feather Falling is 4, and Thorns is 12. And so we've got all these paired up, and then we'll go on to the enchanting phase. So here at our anvil, we have a couple of different options for how we want to do things. First of all, with our boots and our item, it's pretty straightforward. Our boots have to be in the left spot, and then our enchantment has to be in the right, and we'll see this is an enchantment cost of 12. Then for our next pair of books, we're going to have two books, and I believe Thorns is the much more expensive one. I recommend putting the expensive one in the left and the less expensive one in the right. And so we can see that this is an enchantment cost of 4, but if we were to go ahead and swap the order around, again the same books, the enchantment cost is 12. So even if you don't really know what to do, it's always good to go ahead and swap these books and basically just see whatever is a cheaper cost and go ahead and use that. So again, all I'm going down is just going ahead and combining these pairs of books. So this one's 6, and I believe it's with the order, it'll be 4, so go ahead and do the cheaper one, of course. And then this one is 2, the other one is 3, so we're going to want to go ahead and use Mending in the right slot, and Unbreaking 3 in the left slot, and there we go. Our books are now combined a little bit, so we have 4 different items to combine together. Now when combining these books, we're actually going to want to use the most expensive one, again, just like we did earlier, for pairing with our boots. So this is this book, I believe it's 18, you can see the other one is 12, and this one should be 7. So we're going to go ahead and use the most expensive one, and the reason for that is so that we can save levels on down the line, specifically in this stage right here. So we're combining these books together, again, just like earlier, just use the cheapest ones, this one's 7, this one is going to be 12. So we're going to go ahead and swap these around like so, and we get our other book. And the last stage is just to go ahead and combine these two pieces, and we should get a surprisingly low cost of only 21 to get a pair of boots with 7 different enchantments on it. So that was the reason why we gone ahead and used the expensive books earlier, is because we have this relatively cheap book over here, which has a pretty low level of enchantments, so that our final enchantment is cheap enough to actually work on this anvil, and so we can use less levels on down the line, and there we go, we get our pair of boots like so. So our enchanted boots turned out pretty well because we had 8 items in total, so it was pretty easy to go ahead and pair them up. But what happens if we have an odd number of items is that we have to do something a little bit different. But it's all pretty easy so far, so we're going to go ahead and do the same first step, is we're going to go ahead and pair up these items. So first of all, just like earlier, we're going to pair our most expensive book with our item right here on the left, and we're going to have this Curse of Vanishing here. Now we're also going to go ahead and pair up our books just like normal, but we'll see that when we pair up, let's say, Unbreaking and Protection, we're going to have our least expensive book, Mending, left over, which is perfectly fine because we can just go ahead and combine these two books like so. We should get the cheapest one, which should be this option for 3, combine these two with our Mending and get another cost of 3. Then we can just combine our pants and our Curse of Vanishing like so, and it's pretty easy just to combine these for a low cost of 13 levels. Another important thing is to not use items that you have repaired, or armor or weapons that have been sort of used and like unenchanted and whatnot, because that will make your enchanting costs exponentially higher to the point where you might not even be able to put all the enchantments you want to put on there. So even if the material costs are pretty high for you, I would say that it's pretty much always worth it to grab a fresh set of armor or a fresh set of tools or weapons or whatever you're going to enchant with the books and use that instead of your damaged piece. So like I said earlier, the most important thing by far is just to go ahead and pair your items. Pair your books with your boots, pair your books with other books, and just go ahead and move on down the line that way. As you can see, if we go ahead and don't pair them and just use one book at a time, enchanting them in the pretty much the same order we did earlier, we're going to use a ton of levels. We've already used, I think, 32 so far. And as you can see, we just keep on going higher. I think that was 45, even more, gets up to 64, and so on and so forth. As you can see, it just goes higher and higher. For the last enchantment is 65 levels. We've used over 100 levels by far, probably close to 200 levels, using the same enchantment that took around 60 levels last time. So no matter how you do it in what order, the most important thing by far is to go ahead and pair up your books and just do it like that so the enchantment costs don't exponentially increase like we saw earlier. So that's going to do it for today's tutorial. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, don't be afraid to leave a like, and you can subscribe for more content just like this in the future, and I will see you in the next one.
Peace.